This is not just any firepower. It's a deafening, ground-shaking, and destructive force. When the M109 A6 Paladin 155mm self-propelled howitzer roars, the earth trembles and targets shatter. Its booming report isn't just noise. It's the thunderclap of raw power echoing across the battlefield. Each 155mm shell unleashed by this harbinger of devastation, reshaping the landscape and shattering enemy defenses. But behind this fearsome machine, there's a heart of steel and sweat. The gunners. Because any gun, as good as it may be, is just a piece of metal without its crew. Before we delve into its brave personnel, let's try to understand the weapon itself. From an engineering point of view, it's a remarkable machine. The M109 emerged on the battlefield out of a pressing need during the 1960s. The US Army required a self-propelled artillery system to replace its increasingly obsolete collection of aging howitzers. This weapon needed to provide heavier firepower than its predecessors while remaining agile enough to keep pace with the mechanized formations of the era. The M109 has become one of the most prolific self-propelled howitzers in the world, seeing action in numerous conflicts and undergoing continuous upgrades to remain a relevant force today. The M109 A7 is designed similarly to the previous M109, with the driver seat in the front left side of the hull, the power pack to its right, and the turret to the rear. The commander, gunner, ammunition loader, and driver make up the crew of the artillery vehicle. The M109 A7 incorporates the Paladin M109 A6's existing main armament and cab design, while upgrading its chassis with modern components shared with the Bradley fighting vehicle. This enhanced chassis not only offers improved protection, but also ensures greater compatibility with current systems, cutting down on operational maintenance expenses by phasing out outdated parts. Its core is the M284 155mm L39 caliber cannon, paired with a state-of-the-art automated loading system. This electric drive system outperforms the older hydraulic one, offering swifter action. Its automatic rammer ensures rounds are loaded with greater consistency, providing uniform velocities for enhanced accuracy. This howitzer boasts a digital fire control system with an onboard ballistic computer, GPS, and inertial navigation for pinpoint accuracy. Its gun fires standard HE rounds up to 14 miles, rocket-assisted projectiles beyond 18 miles, and precision-guided munitions like the Excalibur. It can unleash destruction at a maximum of 4 rounds per minute, with a sustained rate of 1 round per minute, carrying 39 rounds on board. Don't be fooled by their size. The 155mm shells fired by the M109 Paladins pack a devastating punch. Roughly the length of a baseball bat, each of these projectiles weighs about as much as your average sack of potatoes. High explosive rounds transform into a storm of steel and fire upon detonation, shattering fortifications and tearing through targets caught in the blast. The smoke rounds choke the air, blinding the enemy and masking troop movements. Illumination rounds turn night into day, exposing targets with blinding flares. Newer guided munitions like Excalibur offer pinpoint accuracy, taking out hardened targets with surgical precision. Imagine the force needed to propel such a heavy projectile for miles. When it lands, the impact shakes the ground, the roar rattles your bones, and the destructive aftermath is a sobering testament to the M109's potent firepower. This beast is equipped with cutting-edge electronics and a battle management system that integrates real-time data and communications, making it a smart giant in the field. Equipped with a 600-volt onboard power system, the M109 A7 is primed for additional armor upgrades and the integration of emerging networking technologies. With a weight of 78,000 pounds, it's 10,000 pounds heavier than the model it replaces. Powered by a 675-horsepower Cummins diesel engine, the A7 offers an operational range of 186 miles and a top speed of 39 miles per hour, despite its increased weight. The interior of an M109 A6 Paladin is designed for functionality rather than spaciousness. While not overly comfortable, the crew compartment provides enough room for the four-person crew to perform their tasks. Movement within the howitzer is somewhat limited, especially during active firing, when crew members need to access ammunition, operate the gun, and communicate efficiently. The majority of the internal space is occupied by the 155mm ammunition, the engine, the recoil mechanisms, and supporting systems. Paladin crews operating in these close quarters develop a strong bond. They rely on each other for everything from loading shells to troubleshooting malfunctions. From the section chief calling in fire missions to the gunner aiming the massive 155mm cannon, every individual is vital. It's about synchronized action, not individual heroics. Crew members undergo extensive training to operate, maintain, and fire the howitzer effectively. This includes learning about the artillery system's mechanics, electronics, and ballistics. Precision and accuracy are paramount, given the weapon's role in providing fire support. The nature of artillery operations can be high stress, especially during combat situations. Crew members must make quick, accurate decisions under pressure. The responsibility of delivering fire support accurately to avoid friendly fire adds to the mental load. Beyond operating the howitzer, crew members need to understand tactics, navigation, and communication. They often work with forward observers and need to interpret fire orders accurately. The M109 Paladin's fire mission is a coordinated ballet of destruction, a symphony of calculations, communication, and raw power. The fire mission originates from the Fire Direction Center, or FDC. It includes details like target coordinates, the type of ammunition needed, and any special instructions. The commander within the Paladin receives this data. The commander oversees the entire operation, ensures communication with the FDC, and coordinates crew actions. Paladin can transition from moving to firing in just 30 seconds. Such tactical agility enhances the system's survivability, permitting batteries to spread out in pairs across diverse terrains. This setup allows the howitzer to swiftly relocate after firing or in response to threats from indirect fire, aircraft, or ground forces, significantly improving its operational flexibility and safety on the battlefield.
Fire! Go with it! Get back in there!
Gunner uses maps, computers, and sights to meticulously calculate the firing solution or trajectory for the target based on the received coordinates. He or she also performs pre-fire checks on the gun systems. The loader selects the appropriate ammunition based on the mission requirements and prepares it for loading. The entire crew performs final equipment checks, ensuring smooth operation and safety. Communication is paramount as they confirm everything is in order. Once all checks are complete and confirmation is received from the FDC, the commander grants final authorization. Fire when ready. The gunner pulls the firing lanyard, unleashing a torrent of power. Firing an M109 Paladin is an assault on the senses, a combination of raw power, ear-splitting noise, and a rush of adrenaline. The explosion is not just loud, it's a full-body sonic blast, even with hearing protection. The concussion wave washes over you. The immense noise can damage hearing despite protection. The entire Paladin shudders and jolts backwards despite its immense weight. The recoil system absorbs much of the force, but you might feel it through the floor and in your bones. A cloud of smoke, dust, and the fiery remnants of propellant briefly obscure the view. Crew members, despite this spectacle, remain focused on the next step. Paladin crews take pride in their ability to deliver accurate fire, taking out hardened targets with devastating efficiency. Knowing that your actions deliver heavier firepower to support troops on the ground brings a sense of power and weighty responsibility. As the gun returns to its firing position, it's a race against the clock. The loader rams the next shell into the breech, followed by the propellant charge. Constant communication is vital over the noise and amidst the controlled chaos of reloading during a fire mission. Amidst the noise, crew members shout status updates, adjustments, and confirmations to ensure precision and safety. In scenarios where the initial target isn't fully neutralized, or when new missions arise, the Paladin may hold its position for swift subsequent strikes. However, given that modern militaries possess advanced technology to pinpoint enemy artillery through their firing signatures, the Paladin often needs to relocate after discharging a few salvos to dodge incoming attacks. Incoming fire and battlefield chaos demand quick thinking and a cool head. The adrenaline rush is real, but so is the trust in your crew's training and proficiency. Such relocations typically adhere to predetermined patterns, shifting to alternative, ready firing spots to maintain the element of unpredictability. The M109 A6 Paladin is supported by the M992 ammunition supply vehicle. It can carry a maximum of 93 rounds and transfer them to the self-propelled howitzer via conveyor. These support vehicles are vital for Paladin's steady fire support. After resupplying, this loud warrior continues hammering the enemy with its 155mm fury. This concludes our episode on the mighty M109 howitzer. So, what do you think about this remarkable weapon system? What other pieces of military hardware would you like us to cover in our future episodes? Also, if you were lucky enough to see an M109 howitzer up close, or better yet, served as a crew member, please comment. Remember to hit the subscribe button and ring that bell to stay updated with our latest content. And while you're here, why not check out another one of our exciting videos? Thanks for watching, and see you in the next one.